We've been engaged with the fair conditioning program since 2017, or 16 actually, late 2016. So it's almost 2.5 years since we have been working with the team. And I've done now 2 workshops with Vivek and his team. So the changes have been that it has forced me to look into my own teaching learning processes to a significant extent. Kind of taken me towards re-centering students into this whole process. Otherwise, although you are aware that students are central to it, many times you get carried away by the tradition or you don't really look at it too closely. So once you say that you want to center the student into this whole process of teaching learning, then I guess things are very different. Then you are forced to look into different ways of looking at things. So I remember this caricature that I saw, and we have 2 friends talking, and one friend is telling the other, I have taught my dog to whistle. The other one is obviously furious, so he goes to the dog. The dog is not whistling, obviously. So he says, but the dog is not whistling. So this friend replies, I said I have taught him, I didn't say that he has learned. So this, although it's a funny way of looking at it, but it really underlines the fact that we have focused too much on teaching perhaps and not so much on learning. So although maybe it's peripheral to the idea of looking at sustainability, environmental sensitivity, but for education it becomes a central point from which we need to start. And once you say that you want to enable students to become learners, then a lot of things become easier. So this realization was something that was central to, that was the core thing that I got from the FC program. And once I had kind of zeroed down on this, then we started a series of activities. Fair Conditioning has a very good Udemy course, which is free of cost, and which is something that I brought to the design studio. So that became a prerequisite before the students started their second year design studio. So I was aware that whoever came to the studio had already completed this course and they had a basic understanding of energy transfer, of climate sensitivity, passive means of designing, certain amount of understanding of active ways of climate control as well. So this kind of a background really helps so that you save on studio time, which would go into conceptual learning, and then focus more on its application, which is what the design studio is supposed to be.